fabulites. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Angela, and I just got finished reading The Handmaid's Tale. This is like my fourth time trying to make this recording, and each time I keep saying I should have notes, but I really do not want to go in and make notes because I read the book primarily so that I could review the TV show. I know I don't have to read the book to review the TV show, but that's what I wanted to do, so that's what I did. It was a relatively quick read. I think it took me probably less than 6 hours to read it. Overall, I found the book kind of depressing. I do really, really enjoy, you know, kind of more rebellion. I'm a rebellious sort. So I really enjoyed that. I tweeted a couple of things, but most of the things that I tweeted were things that I would not retweet because I'd be like, that's not really upbeat or encouraging. And it reminds me also of like in watching the TV show Underground, which I love to watch. For example, one of the characters, Ernestine, has been using drugs and kind of like in a depressed state. And people are like, come on, Ernestine, shake out of it. Come on, you know, fight, fight, fight. And there was a part where I think that the main character wanted her friend Moira, I don't know how to pronounce her name, but wanted her to be more, to fight more. But I feel like when I'm listening to people talk that way about Ernestine, I'm like, shoot, sometimes in life, you know, you can't be fighting all the time. You know, people take times to rest and times to process. It's like when you're homeschooling children, they don't learn all the time. You know, it's like seasons. There's a time for studying. There's a time for being quiet. There's a time for reflecting. There's a time for planning. There's time for all sorts of things. So just because someone is not, you know, just rebellious all the time don't mean, you know, they don't have any spunk or fight in them. But I did not find the book to be like inspirational, like, yes. I like the whole Mayday thing. As soon as she said Mayday, I was like, Mayday, Mayday, you know, Mayday, shake her up. So I like that. I found that it was like such a small slice of one small person's very small world that was kind of frustrating. But I also think it was frustrating as a reader, like what's going on, what's happening in the rest of the world. And when she asked the commander, you know, I want you to tell me about what's going on in the world, I was like, yes, I want to know more about what's going on in the world. And when we get glimpses of the news, I was kind of like, huh? And when she lost her job and they took away her bank account, I'm like, the first thing I would have done was turn on the news. But I didn't see her do that. But, you know, while I found that frustrating, you know, as a reader, I think it's probably really exciting as a creative person, like, you know, becoming a TV show. And I read that there was a film made in 1990 that I might check out. I got so many things on my list. But as a creative, I think it just gives them a lot of creative license to create, you know, something very creative and interesting. They have some broad strokes and they have a lot of room to fill in. So it's kind of like a watercolor, you know, like you get this wash of an idea of, you know, what this world is like and what, you know, what's going on. And I think, you know, so I think that will make for an interesting television show, or the potential for an interesting television show. The woman who just got killed off of Fear of the Walking Dead, the black woman, was her name Sasha? Is she in Handmaid's Tale? I guess I'll see shortly. But I'm glad I read someplace that in the original Handmaid's Tale, although I could barely tell, they said that the black people had been sent off to, I heard something about a bomb in Detroit or the children of Ham. So I guess that's the black and brown people, I don't know, but that they had been sent off, and so there wouldn't have been any black people in The Handmaid's Tale. But in the TV version, they do have, you know, that woman who I think played Sasha on Fear the Walking Dead. So I'm kind of excited. I'm looking forward. I'm like, oh, a black person. I think she was in Orange is the New Black too. I think I've seen her around a couple of times, although I haven't watched Orange is the New Black in a couple few seasons. What else? I could really, you know, as a black woman, you know, it's like this whole idea of dominating people and holding people down and trying to keep them from reading and trying to keep them in line and, you know, having them be objects and having them be things, or trying to, you know, trying to keep make a human being an object. I could really relate to that. You know, as a black person, as a woman, you know, as a black woman, you know, it's all of that with intensity, you know, constantly coming from so many different directions. What else? Did I have any other? I said that overall the book was, it was a quick read. I think it took me 6 hours. I might have already said that. What else? That may be all that I have. I did tweet a couple things, but my Twitter is on my tablet, so I would have to pull those off. So the keeping people from reading, the fact that when Moira escaped, she said that, and there was an underground female road. And the fact that when she escaped, it was like most people didn't really know anything about what was going on. And that reminds me a little bit of, in, you know, when there were first concentration camps or whatever. And I guess even later on with concentration camps, most people didn't know what was going on in there. And I guess also like plantations or prisons in this country, most people don't really know what's going on in there. It's only a few people who are a part of that system who have any, you know, insight or understanding or experience of that system. Or I don't want to say it. Yeah. So, that might be it. The Handmaid's Tale. I guess that I would recommend, you know, reading the book. I've never read Clockwork Orange or 1984. I have read the children's series that they made the movie about, The Hunger Games. So I, you know, I would recommend reading it, I guess. I mean, I wouldn't like be like, I'm not like rush out and go read it right now, like I am about Underground. I'm like, go out and go watch it right now. But, you know, I'm kind of like, yeah, you know, it's, I'm not mad that I read it. I don't feel like I wasted my time. I don't feel like it was a hard read. And I think, you know, it's a good orientation into this new, you know, world. Although I'm, as a TV show, they always know how to bring you into a new world. So I wasn't really necessarily concerned about that. So that might be all I have. What you got? What you think? Did you read the book? Would you recommend the book? Are you watching the series? Are you smelling me? What does my ear smell like? You old wild dog who tried to attack me. So that's all I got. Thanks for, listening to my quick review recap of The Handmaid's Tale. It's, set like maybe like in 2020. I don't know when it's set, but let's say it's about 2020 and it's, America has become a place called Gilead, or parts of America have become a place called Gilead, and women are divided into categories. Like there are the handmaids who are fertile women. There are the Marthas who are infertile women, who the handmaids who are fertile work as, you know, they have babies. They work at being fertile. And then there are the Marthas who are house, like maids and cooks. And then there are the Econo-wives. I wanted to see more about them. They, the Marthas wear green, the handmaids wear red, the wives wear blue. And I guess the wives just run the household. And I guess only the commanders, the people who are high up in the religious sect, have wives. Other people get econo wives. And then there were other men around, and I was trying to understand, like, who are they involved with? Do they have econo wives? Like Nick, who our main character ended up getting into an affair with, you know, I'm like, does he have an econo wife? Is he eligible for an econo wife? How does he get a wife? How can he move up and become a commander? I mean, there, I had so many questions about how the world worked. And then this whole idea of being called of Glenn or of Charles or of Warren as a woman, I didn't necessarily think that that was radical. It seemed like the same thing as being called Mrs. Rasulullah or Mrs. Burke or Mrs. Puerto Rico or Mrs. Porter. It seems like, you know, as women, you go from, you know, in this society, to me, symbolically, you're owned by, you know, your father. And then that's coming from a women's college. That's how I look at stuff. And then you go into ownership. You become of your husband. You become Mrs. So-and-so. You know, you go from being your father's daughter to your husband's wife. And in between there, what is your value? And, you know, and your value is only important in the context of being a wife or, you know, a child in some way. So, and the Econo-wives, this, and I want to see the costume, because the imagery for the, look, I'm getting all excited about the TV show. I guess I'm image, like, you know, but the imagery of the red was very beautiful. And the Econo-wives had, they had red, green, and blue stripes on their dress, because they were every woman. I'm every woman. And then there were, like, you know, prostitutes. And then after you became, you know, after you weren't useful, I guess you, or if you were too old to be useful, or if you were, you know, disobedient, they worked you to death. And I guess it was like a lot of pollution in the world. And that's why people had become infertile and why they needed people to have. So I don't know. It's not really much of a recap, but it's what I got. I think I'm finished talking about it. I'm gonna, I don't know when I'm gonna get a chance to, watch it, but, I do know that on Wednesday night, one of my shows that I have been reviewing is in a mid-season break, and I still don't know what that means, but it, what it does mean is that I have time to slip Handmaid's Tale in there. I'm probably gonna do one episode at a time. Oh, and also I think that The Real Housewives of Atlanta, which I've been reviewing, will go off tonight, so that'll free up a little bit more space in time. Oh, but I wanted to see Dear White People. So look, I'm taking out two and adding in two. Y'all know I don't know how to act. Anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for being here, spending a little bit of time with me. Have a wonderful, wonderful rest. Look, that's what somebody else says. Have a wonderful, wonderful rest of your day. And I'm planning on doing the same as well. I do. But be you. Be fabulous. Be fabulous, you. Mwah. Bella knows that means we about to leave. She getting up. Bye, y'all.